Hey, so how's it going? Just going to be a small stream tonight. Just going to be going through some of the Hack the Box retired boxes. As these are retired, then there's no issues with me showing them on the stream and grabbing the flags as we go along. It is locked down a bit if you do this to boxes which are still live. Also, to do this with retired machines, you do need the VIP subscription. So I've got three boxes lined up tonight. Got one Linux box and two Windows boxes. So we'll crack on with those and see what happens. So the boxes I've got tonight are Lame, Legacy, and Devel. So we're going to see if we can get through these and see what we can do. So let's crack on with the first one. First things first, let's put a localhost entry in for this machine so that we don't have to keep typing the IP address. And let's connect to the VPN. That's our VPN IP address. And let's just get chat window up as well. Okay, so first things first, let's start getting set up to take our notes. First thing we're going to do is run a nmap scan. Missed an S. Stop. Set this replying to pings. Just out PN, shouldn't make any difference. So 139 Samba, 22 SSH. so let's search in summer. Just run that again. See what comes back with. Right, it's just been rebooting, which is always a pain with Hack the Box. So this time it's brought back 21 as well, which is FTP. Yeah, so we've got BSFTP and anonymous login is allowed. So that's interesting. So we'll probably hit that one first. So copy that and into Cherry Tree. So BSFTPD anonymous login is allowed. Off. So the password for anonymous login, just type any random email address and it normally takes that. And we're in. Nothing in directories, so what's for anything hidden? New /. Looks like we're rooted somewhere and there's no documents. Anything else we can look at? User. Let's just change different user. Okay, so there's nothing there. So let's have a look if there's anything in Metasploit for BSFTPD. 3.4. Okay, so there's a backdoor execution in Metasploit for this. So let's give that a go. So let's search BSFTPD again. And let's have a look at this exploit. So it needs the remote host, remote port, and that is it. So let's set our hosts to lame. Else, so let's see if check will work with this. Does not support check. Okay, let's run the exploit then. Completed, no sessions were created. Alright then, let's set payload. Just in case it needs payload setting. Don't need to set any other options. So let's run that again. Okay, so it doesn't look like that's going to let us in. So let's have a look at our cherry tree. What else did we have? So FTP, SSH, and we did also have a Samba open. So let's use DBN map minus P 445 439 C SV script. Let's have a look at some vulnerabilities, our name, and make it verbal so that we can just see what it's doing. Such a pain tonight. It pings, so it's not blocking probes. But I'll just give it PN anyway. Let's see if it does anything. It's finally the ports are open. Myself a refreshment when we're waiting for this. Probably not the best idea to do it over my keyboard, but so we've got Samba 3 to 4. Those are all old boxes that I've been doing. I think 10.10.3. Alright Mark, not bad. Just crack on with this first box, which has been a bit of a pain in the ass. Okay, so got a few Samba exploits in here. So just get rid of that in that front side. so there's a heap overflow. Okay, not sure what lounge that is, but it's not my forte. Pretty sure there was a Samba vulnerability for this one. Let's have a look at this one. OSX probably isn't going to be that one. Let's see if we can get anything out of this box. So that's our host sleep. Let's get a payload. What we got? Let's do a reverse. What we got? Bash Toner, let's not get. Try an SSH. What do we need to do? So I'll set the L-host. SetG sets it globally, so we won't have to type it if we keep switching payloads. Listen port 22. TTL port. Set that to 222. Possibly doesn't have the payload. So let's try a different payload. Let's just do reverse. Generic. Let's have a look at the options. Command to run. Set sim. To shell, and let's give that a run. Something like that. So, This one is being a pain. Just set the payload for now. Try that again. Mission denied. Find. Trying to do that, we're going to set the payload. So I need to run this route. No, it's not liking that. Let's just give this box a reset. Pain in the backside. See if this brings back any difference. Now that we'll give her a reset. So if we get anything this time, we'll just move on to the next box and then I'll terminate this one and start it back up again. Now it decides to reboot. So with the retired boxes, there are normally a ton of write-ups to explain how to do them. Yeah, but it's always best to try and do it yourself before you have a look at the write-ups. And what you normally get as well is a official write-up tutorial from Hack the Box or from the box's author. Okay, so let's back up. Another go. See if we bring back anything different now that we've given a bit of kick in the ass. Yeah, it does ruin the fun, Mac. But sometimes, even if you've done the box without reading the write-ups, it's always good to go back and read them, because you find that some of them get the flags in different ways, and it's good to see how others apply their tradecraft. You can always pick up some good pointers, even after the fact. And as the old adage goes, if you're not learning, then you're not earning. Okay, still not bringing anything back. Let's have another look for Samba 3. Okay, let's point out Joel, somebody using him, script. Okay, let's wait for this. Link. Brilliant. Let's have a Samba. Okay, so a remote cord injection. Some exploits and see if we can use this. Options, G, host to lame, and let's give that a run. Well, hey. So, this has been a bit of a pain in the backside, but we've got a command shell session. Where are we? Oh, brilliant, we're root. So, this should make it a bit easier. So, let's get a decent a shell on the door. Import pty, pty.spawn bin mash. Cool, got a nice prompt. So with hack the box, there's normally a users.txt and a root.txt. So the users.txt is normally in home under an unprivileged user. So let's just have a look. So on this one, it's under Marcus. And there's our user flag. So that's taken probably half an hour longer than it should have done with the issues with the box. So let's own our user. And to be honest, it wasn't that difficult once we got there. Cool. And so as we're already root, get into root home directory, and there's a root.txt. So I'll copy that off, and we're on root. So that one exploit gave us both flags, which is always good. Have a look what's actually listening on here. So 512 XNS ID. Interesting. 139445, we know. Yeah, it's got Apache on there. Maybe. W running, so a bit weird when all those ports showed up on the initial scan, but we'll take that as a win. And we'll come out of that and we'll terminate that. Yep, and we'll come out of exploit. So that's lame done. So take that off our to-do list. Okay, so next box is a Windows box. Legacy. Anything else we're missing? Nope. So let's just run our mmap scan. Moving on to the left. To the left. that off. Okay, so what we've got here, 1, 3, 4, 4, 5. So it's got Windows Shares open, it's Windows XP. And this is probably gonna be quite easy. So we've got MS-08067, which is the NetAPI vulnerability. And you'll probably find that there's some of the Eternal Blue vulnerabilities that will probably run against this as well, as it's an old box and hasn't been updated. So the Eternal Blue vulnerability was the one which was to do with WannaCry or WannaCrypt. So again, we'll use Metasploit. So you can search via the Microsoft article. Or you can search via the CVE. So it's the WannaCry one. That one. So this one here, MS-08087. So this is going to be the NetAPI one. So what we'll do is we'll use the older one. So if you go on the Certified Ethical Hacker course, or a lot of the hacker training that's provided by different training companies, you'll still be targeting a lot of XP boxes, and this NetAPI vulnerability is one that comes up quite a lot. So we'll use that. Let's have a look at the options. So I need to set our hosts. And let's have a look at what payloads there are. And there's quite a few. So we'll use Trusted Old Interpreter Reverse TCP. As we came out of Metasploit, it's forgotten now localhost, so we'll just add that back in. And let's give that a go. And just like that, we're in. So we're in System 32. So let's just drop through a shell. So on Windows, we can use percent username percent. So put on as a legacy user account. Okay, so I'll just exit that shell. Let's have a look at the server to help. And let's just try to get system. Easy as that. I gotta love having XP machines hanging about it. So load memory cats if you want to just get using password hashes. Domain user legacy. That's three. See if it brings back anything. So network service, there's a LAN manager hash there. But all we're interested in is flags. So let's go hunting. Uh, And as is XP, we've got documents and settings instead of users, as with Windows 7 and later. So let's go into John's directory. Desktop. And here's the user flag. Let's go and submit that. And again, that was a nice easy box to get the user flag on. There's the root flag on the administrator's desktop. And we'll submit that. And that was really easy to get. So there's our second box tonight. And as you've seen, that took less than 10 minutes really. So sometimes you do get boxes which are just a pain in the backside, and other times you get boxes which you just fly through. So Deval, let's fire that up. Okay, I've already got a machine. So let's terminate that one. A couple minutes and then we'll try and restart the next one. Come on. So I'm just going to have to wait for this one to terminate. Okay, let's have a look what other side machines are actually turned on at the moment. So Lane we've done, Lexi we've done, Grandpa. Okay, so it looks like it's possibly another easy box. So let's just give this an end map. And see what we get with this one. taking this time. So I've got CV, CTF, enumeration, real life, so it shouldn't be that difficult. Again, you've got all different walkthroughs. Okay, so this one looks a bit more interesting. Let's copy that off. So we've got port 80 open. IIS, and looks like it's got phpMyAdmin on there, so let's have a look at this in the browser. PHPMyAdmin on there. It's got front page. Just add my /bin. Can't tell what it's at there. Block page source, nothing interesting. What we already know. PCI bin. PCI off. So what we'll do is we'll be more aggressive on port 80. See if this will enumerate any directories to try and figure out where that PHP management was. Nope. Okay, so we'll leave Derp running in the background. So search flight, and nothing for that. I'm going to spot DB in the background. Okay, it's not finding anything. So we've got a pull script. So host is where PHP is. PHP. Exclusion. Looks like we need to know. Let's have a look at front page, what we got. So we've got the IIS front page buffer overflow exploits. Give that a go. So 2000 SP0 to SP3. Not sure. So set our host's wrapper and just give that a run. See what it brings back. Doesn't look promising. So what did we have? We had some scanners. Set G, our host's trigger ramper. Let's have a look. Credentials saved in. Nope, so I didn't find anything. Let's try the other scanner. Port 80. that support front page server extensions. Okie doke. So, this one is another one that looks like it's going to be a pain. Let's see if I can find the OS. Bypass. Looks like I'm a bot. Don't think I am. So, version of iOS installed on remote host is affected by an authentication bypass vulnerability, possible to access PHP files and protect web directories. Okay, so we've got a script. There's access protected directory. Nothing else there. So, is this brought back anything different? disclosed in 2005. 264. Net, nothing for that. Pull back. And we'll try C Windows System 32 drivers etc hosts. Parameters incorrect. Okay, so we're not having much luck with this. Now let's break up the zap. Give it a good scan. Automated scan. Got 500 response, was expecting 200. By there. Yeah, okay, so that's not gonna help. So you think it could be similar to with IIS 6MR, do you? So look at IS6, what got your internal IP address? Not Stack Overflow, not FTP, web dev remote authentication bypass. So, do you think 874 Mac? That's bypass restrictions, work with servers. So have we got anything interesting for web dev? Got an upload ASP. Set host grandpa and we use Windows interpreter. Reverse TCP options set our host to. I should really write this down. So it doesn't like that one. Host. Thank you. not liking that. Devel's been spawned into the lab. Let's have a look. We don't get the under construction. So, what's Grandpa's IP address? Is it simply that because we're using a host name, we're not getting what we want? Nope. So, I wonder if there's something bust on this box. So, we'll try that. One there. Let's just try that one again. So we'll try it 417. So let's jump into Metasploit. Set. Let's just give that a run. Set payload. Windows, Meta-Opter, reverse TCP. So I wonder if the last person to have a play with this box decided to break a couple of things. So, yeah, we can see here that exploit should have worked. So, again, it looks like something's throwing us a bit of a wobbler. So, let's reset this box. And give that a couple of moments to reboot. Yeah, I'm acting as a Metasploit module, but it's not working, so it looks like someone might have been playing with the box and just caused a few issues for us. So, I had this with the first box as well, where after a reset, the exploit worked without an issue. Yeah, that's the nice thing with Trihackme, you do get your own box when you start it up. Whereas with Hack the Box, yeah, you do get communal boxes. So we've been going for 1 hour 20 and we've only hit two boxes so far. Again, the first one took about 35 minutes due to issues. The second one took about 10 minutes. And then this one again is just taking an age. So hopefully it should reset. Looks like we're losing some pings. And as it's a Windows box, it'll take a bit longer than the Linux box to come up. So when we just wait for that to update the services, I'm just going to take a quick break. I'll be back in a couple minutes. Okay, so let's go and hit that page again. Under construction, that looks a lot better than what we had last time. So what we'll do is we'll just run our nmap again. And see what we get back this time. Let's just make a note of that. So what we've got this time, got a web dev scan, no PHP this time. Okey-doke. So options, and let's run this again. And what do you know? straight away we've got a session. Which is just typical. Spend all that time trying different exploits, and in the end, all I needed was a reboot. Okay, so who am I? So we're the network service. So let's see where we can get to. So as we're just going after flags. Can I get into Harry? Okie doke. So let's try the old git system. Access denied. Okay, so I will back around that and we'll search for exploit suggestion. So we'll try this. If not, then we'll pull down Limpies and see if that can bring back any different suggestions for privilege escalation. Services run, but can be validated. So we've got a few different exploits there which we can try. So try MS-14. Okay. Do hash temp new, can't do get priv. What else we got? Then that didn't work. Okay, system even. Yeah, operation failed. So what we got? Let's try Minikets. I really cannot type sync. SSP. New doesn't look like we've got anything there. So to... Burn XPs. We'll use the batch script. Should have access to upload to here. Upload WinPs. That's snide. PID. Okay, so we need somewhere we can write to init pub maybe. Root. Okay. See Windows system 32. Spool. My surface is not having much fun here. CD drivers, CD color. It's a pain in the ass, it's the American spelling all the time. And let's try and upload it here. Access denied. That's weird. Because that should be writable by everyone. Okay, so let's think about this. What can we try? See if we can load PowerShell. Nope, that's completely killed our session. Brilliant. So we still need correct exploits. No, we're not. History. Which one did we use? It was the ISDEG one. So let's jump back into there. Options, and let's just give that a rerun. Let's see if we can get back on the box. And our session was created. Here we go again. No active sessions. Options. Oh, that's correct. So check our box again, make sure it hasn't gone into a weird state. Yeah, it's in that weird state again. Okay, so we'll knock Grandpa on the head for now, because that is just being a complete and utter BH tonight. and go back to the Devel box, which we booted up. I'm pretty sure we booted that up. Yep. So we'll do this one and probably go back to Grandpa next week. I'll give it a fresh reboot and try and find a region where I'm the only one playing with it. Okay, so let's crack on with scanning this. Okay, so we've got 8021, so HTTP and FTP. Anonymous FTP login is allowed. And it looks like there's a few files on there. So let's jump onto that. Be lazy. We've got ASPS clients, welcome, and ISSTAT. So let's have a look. Yeah, view image, welcome.png, welcome.png. Okay. So, looks like we've got access to the web root, which is good. So, I wonder if we've got upload access there. So, touch just creates the file with the current timestamp. What you can do is not really related to what we're doing now, but you can use touch with the minus D flag and set the timestamp. So if you want to use the find command to find files newer or older than a certain time, what you can do is you can use touch to create a file with a timestamp and then just use newer or older using that file. So it's really good, especially if you want to clear out a load of old log files. More from the sysadmin world, really. So let's see if we can put that file there. Okay, so we can upload stuff to here. To IIS, Windows. Let's have a look. ASPX reverse shell. PHP, Netcat, Telnet, Perl, Ruby, Glock, Kali, Shells. Okay, so we've got SPX there. Okay, so I'll copy that to here and then we'll put that file onto the server. Close that. Don't need any of those. Don't want that. Okay, so we've got a reverse shell there. So what else we got? If we've got that, what can we do? Is that running from there? Where are we? And it's serve. Okay, look. So, Windows reverse shell. Okay, so stop being about our golden rule. Take notes. This. Sure, if this will work or not. So let's just see if we can hit that on our VPN address before we try the command. URL and const reverse shell. What we need to do is msHTA and the path to our script. So let's try that in our web shell. Deliver a payload. If we get any sessions yet, nope. Okay. So this has been a bit of a pain in the backside. See, and a pub www root. Okay, so we can see inside there. So we'll just try that again. Deliver payload. Let's see if we get anything off this. Empire. listeners. Okay, so that's the Hack the Box one. Since I've used this, okay, we've cloned it, we're running it. So, how do we create a listener again? Okay, so use listener HTTP. Set name HTTP 2. And I really can't type tonight. Set host to HTTP. Address again. Okay, so I've got HTTP 2 81 and our VPN address. Set. Do we need to change anything else? New execute listeners. Okay, so now I've got a second listener. So let's just open that link up. Yep, so that looks to be working. Okay. What else we got? New stager. Windows. Launch a batch. Set. Listener HTTP 2 language PowerShell set. That was true. Obviously, command should be all right. So let's execute that. That into CTF Deville. And City Estevelle. So what we'll do is we'll put that. Okay, so we've lost that connection there. And we must. I really can't take tonight. And then must me. Logged in. So we'll put that there. So launcher.files there. So let's try and see if we can do cpub /new. Launcher.bat. No, it didn't like that. Okay, so it's just going to do that. So let's see users. Babis. Nope. Let's have a look at what's open on the box. Not a lot open apart from FTP, SSH, SMB. Let's have a look. Sessions, didn't create any SMB client myself. So, NSN, Devel. Action successful. Okay, so that didn't bring anything back. See if we can use different exploit attack. Permission denied to bind. Okay. Really don't like running Metasploit as root. else we got? New stager. Windows, what we got? HTA, obviously isn't gonna work. Try this one first. So I'll set that to the VPN address. Says our host. Yeah, Venom would be able to make a exploit or a payload that we could deliver. Just try this via the ASPX web shell, because as we know with a lot of Apache and Linux stuff, the web shells do work in getting you a remote session. So let's see if this will work. So I'm just thinking about it. Thinking on something in there. No sessions created yet though. Now port equals 9999. Now port equals rev.exe. That's probably completely wrong considering I've done it from memory. Okay, I don't trust that whatsoever. But let's just put rev.exe there. And we're logged out again. Anonymous me@you.com. I am really sorry. Rev.exe. I can never remember this. Use generic handler. I agree, Rapid 7. Exploit multi-handler, that's the one. Set payload. Windows, interpreter. Reverse TCP. Set our host to 10.10.14.33. Set our port to 999. And well, that's new for that. So we'll go back here and we'll do C and pub root rev.exe. Exploit that. Let's have a look at that then, Max. So, MSF Venom ESPX. ESP. Let's try this. Return 10.14.33. Really quick again. And it doesn't like that for whatever reason. If we got any others, SP, Windows, shell.exe, SPX. So is it just a case of changing the format to SPX? So IS web again. Davis. Access denied still. Really, I'm having issues tonight. Nope. Okay, so let's see if we can get system. Nope. LCD. Peace. Migrate normally only works between the same user, or sometimes there are a few others. Run WinPs at the moment. So there's quite a few updates not installed there, which may give us some options. It's not as good as the Linux one, you don't get nice highlighting. Let's try and use Mimikatz. That session by refreshing that page. Yes, I did. I'm an idiot. So let's get back connected. And what we'll do is before we run the WinPs again, I'll just try the migrate as Mark suggested. Just wait for this to come up. So we're at Apple Web. So what we got? Yes, there's a PowerShell that I actually running. Wonder if that's from when we were trying PowerShell Empire earlier. So we've got system, SMS, SSS, Rundle. So the one that most people use is spool.serve. So let's see if we can migrate into that. Nope. Insufficient privileges. Which is a bit of a bugger. So just back on this. Yes. It's always worth a try, Mark. Set session, what session we're in two, and give this a run. one. See if this brings back anything. So we've got to the end of 2 hours and we've done 2 boxes out of 4. So not brilliant. So have we got anything which is a escalation of privilege? Possibly. So let's try this. What do we need here? Session. And session died again. Not good. Info. Let's get UA bypass. So rerun that. Let's get our session back. Not having a good night tonight. Come on. Background that. Use that. Options, set session to 3. Let's try that, see what happens. Not an admin group, cannot escalate. Okay, so let's go back to our Linux P's. Our WinPs. Run that again. Now that we've got a shell in the box, we could try the launch.bat to get PowerShell Empire running again. So after WinPs, I'll give that a go. Yes, still looking for the clipboards for anything. In the meantime, let's have a read through. So, Windows 7 Enterprise. So, original install date 2017. Few patches there that's missing. Detail accessing, apps installed, don't really care about that. Cache credentials, need system to extract them, which we haven't got. USC bypass, we tried that, but it came back saying we couldn't do it because and have right permissions. Just Check for vulnerabilities, VMware tools, new, remote desktop. Credentials manager, nothing there, process, nothing there, running processes, running startup, always install unlimited, new, access nice to the shares, network interfaces, use ports, 445, didn't show up in our scan, I don't think. Nope. Still looking at the clipboard. Firewall is enabled. So that's probably why we can't see the shares, even though the ports are open. Outbound is alright. Firewall log. DTO's not that fussed in at the moment. Wi-Fi we don't really care about. Okay, so we've got a couple privileges maybe. Still looking at the clipboard. Okay, so I just brought back a few services that may be interested. Maybe DLL hijacking. Okay, well, that's doing that. Let's just borrow some brains. Priv-SIS web. Okay, so it looks like there's a missing software patch. Which we can use. So it's always funny when you just try and Google stuff without Googling what you're Googling, and it brings back the actual box that you're doing. So what we'll do is we'll try the exploit suggester again. After this is finished. Let's go back up to the top and see what updates we were missing. It's getting close to 11:30, so I might just do is have a cheeky look at that right up. So yeah, we did the web shell bits. Excuse you that. Found out who we were. Got a shell on the box. So it looks like possibly we could use Nishin. Interpreter, which is what we use, previous installation, web to system, system info, short for patches that applied. So this kind of version.net installed. Okay, I don't really feel like doing a completion of Watson LS11.6. So did we see that as missing? LS11.6. No. Didn't flag that ref as missing. So, does this rely on Watson being recompiled? Okay, so, just take a copy of WinPies. Got the default username there, so just try that. Reg query and the key. Username, auto admin login is off. Haven't got a default password. That's fair enough. And anything else? Unquartered service paths. Possibly, maybe able to do some of the doors. Service boundaries with WOMAC. Okay, so we'll try the exploit suggestion again. Set session to free. That run. To be honest, I've not got the ability to rebuild Dr. Watson at this time, so I'm not going to try that one. Got a schedule elevator, so we'll try that. Uh, session 3, set payload, Windows, interpreter, reverse TCP, options, SSL port 24445, SSL host 10.10.14.33, and we'll run that, and I like it. C pub. It's Windows dir root dir, and I'll try launch.bat. Doesn't like that. So what else we got? So we're gonna try the, let's try the HCA use stager. Let's see all that. Yes. Use stager Windows. Let's get true, execute that. In. Meetup.com. Just up in. No, doesn't look like that. Did anything? Okay, so nothing going through on agents. And we'll probably just kill that shell. Okay, I give up. Let's go to. One of the readmes. Really don't like doing this, but. Someone you don't want to look at. Is it going to need to compile Dr. Watson? If it is, I'm just going to give up. We get in the box, system info, search log exploit, log exploit suggestion. And they use the kit. Yep, so I session, yep. Okay, we've still got our session, so that's good. So we'll background that. I hate having to use the walkthroughs, but sometimes it can't be helped. So session, so we're still session three. And no session created. Try again. This is our port. Now host 10 10 14 33. Timed out. And 10 14 33, that's right. Has our session died? Yes, it has. Handler rerun. Oh, tonight's been a pain. Lucky enough, it's just a web page to get the session back up and running. Otherwise, I think I would have just turned off. Losing the will a bit. Okay, so let's background that. There, have a look at our options. Session is now session four, and let's try that. We've just spent half an hour trying to that, and we're in 2 minutes after we get the right bits. Frustrating. Come out the shell, PS. So see a lot more stuff, and because we don't know if this session is going to die again, let's find our trusty old spool server. Service is there, so even if our ESPX session does die now, migrated to a stable process, well, hopefully, unless this fobs us off. Okay, cool. So that's better. So let's go see if we can get these flags. Okay, so Ah, that's a pain in the ass. User.txt.txt. Sometimes you only need one hint to get you there. It was easy-ish. And I wonder if this is .txt.txt. Yep. So that would have been a bit of a pain in the ass again. And there's our root flag. So, accepted 4 boxes and completed 3. So, I'll probably go off, have a look at Grandpa tomorrow. I might stream it. But that was a bit of a more epic night than I thought it would be. Thanks a lot for tuning in. Hopefully for some of you it's been interesting. What I'll do is I'll export the Twitch stream to YouTube, just so this hangs about a bit longer than 14 days. And I think with that, I am going to call it a night. Stay safe over the weekend. Enjoy it. And take care of yourselves.